हेलो, हम लोग क्लास 12th की फिजिक्स पे बात कर रहे हैं और फिजिक्स में इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक पोटेंशियल एंड कैपेसिटेंस के क्वेश्चन कर रहे हैं। ब्रेक से पहले हमने क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 to 6 डिस्कस किया था। ब्रेक के बाद अब आगे क्वेश्चन डिस्कस करते हैं बिना समय गवाएं। और ये क्वेश्चन नंबर 7 है। 3 कैपेसिटर्स और कैपेसिटेंस 2 पिकोफेराड, 3 पिकोफेराड एंड 4 पिकोफेराड आर कनेक्टेड इन पैरेलल। What is the total capacitance of the combination and determine the charge on each capacitor if the combination is connected to 100 volt supply। So question में ऐसा है कि यहां से ये point है और इस point से 3 capacitor connected है। एक capacitor ये है, एक capacitor ये है और एक capacitor ये, मान लीजिए तीनों connected हैं और तीनों के एंड पॉइंट्स एक ही पॉइंट है यहाँ पे, और तीनों को एक सप्लाई से कनेक्ट कर दिया गया है। और ये सप्लाई है कितने की, तो 100 वोल्ट की सप्लाई है। 100 वोल्ट की सप्लाई है ईच इक्वल। यहाँ से ये करंट फ्लो हो रहा है, तो इधर कुछ चार्ज जा रहा होगा Q1, इधर कुछ चार्ज जा रहा होगा Q2 और इधर कुछ चार्ज जा रहा होगा Q3। इसकी कैपेसिटेंस है C1, इसकी C2 और इसकी C3। सो कैपेसिटेंस अलग है बट दोनों पॉइंट के बीच का पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस जो है वो सेम है, क्योंकि सबका टर्मिनल ए पर है एक कनेक्शन, दूसरा कनेक्शन बी पे है, तो इनके बीच का पोटेंशियल जो है वो भी है, वो सबके लिए सेम, पोटेंशियल सेम है। अब C1 अगर 2 माइक्रोफेराड है, ये हम 2 पिकोफेराड, C2 जो है वो 3 पिकोफेराड है और C4 जो है वो है, C3 जो है 4 पिकोफेराड है। इक्विवेलेंट कैपेसिटेंस C इज गिवन बाय C1 प्लस C2 प्लस C3। पैरेलल कॉम्बिनेशन नहीं होता है, आपको पता है, याद है ना। तो ये हो गया 2 प्लस 3 प्लस 4 पिकोफेराड, दैट इज 4 × 3 = 7, 9 पिको फेराड। सो कैपेसिटेंस हो गया 9 पिको फेराड कॉम्बिनेशन में। तो व्हाट इज द टोटल कैपेसिटेंस ऑफ द कैपेसिटर, दैट इज 9 पिको फेराड। नाउ डिटरमिन द चार्ज ऑन इन ईच कैपेसिटर इफ द कॉम्बिनेशन इज कनेक्टेड टू 100 वोल्ट सप्लाई। सो C1 इज इक्वल टू क्या होता है, हमें चार्ज निकालना है Q इज इक्वल टू, तो Q1 इज इक्वल टू क्या हो जाएगा, C1 भी और Q2 इज इक्वल टू C2 भी। सो Q1 इज इक्वल टू C1 भी, वोल्टेज सबके लिए सेम है। Q2 इज इक्वल टू C2 भी और Q3 इज इक्वल टू C3 भी। Q1 है चार्ज, अब C1 कितना है, तो C1 है 2 पिको फेराड, 2 × 10⁻²⁰ फेराड इंटू वोल्ट है 100, सो दैट विल बी 200 × 10⁻²⁰ कूलम, राइट ना। दैट कैन बी ऑल्सो फर्दर रिटे जाए 2 × 10⁻¹⁰ कूलम, −10 कूलम, ठीक है, ऐसा लिख सकते हैं। Q2 इज इक्वल टू 3 × 10⁻¹² इंटू 100 इज इक्वल टू 300 × 10⁻¹² कूलम, दैट इज 3 × 10⁻¹⁰ कूलम, एंड दिस कैन बी रिटन एज 4 × 10⁻¹² इंटू 100, सो दैट विल बी 400 × 10⁻¹² कूलम, दैट इज 4 × 10⁻¹² कूलम। सो दैट कैन बी रिटन एज लाइक दिस। So this is the charge, different charge through the each of the branch for each capacitor. I hope this is easy question and I hope you definitely got this, right na? अब इसको माइक्रो कूलम में भी चाहे तो लिख सकते हैं, ऐसी कोई बात नहीं है। माइक्रो कूलम, नैनो कूलम लिख सकते हैं अगर इसको चाहे तो, कोई दिक्कत वाली बात नहीं है, जैसा आप चाहे वैसा लिख सकते हैं। नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 8। In a parallel plate capacitor with air between the plates, each plate has an area 6 × 10⁻³ meter square. A distance between them is is 3 millimeter. Calculate the capacitance of the capacitor. If the capacitor is connected to 100 volt supply, what is the charge on each plate of the capacitor? So here what is given? Area of plate is given. A is given 6 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter square. Distance between the plates is also given 3 millimeter, that is 3 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. Right now? So calculate, and voltage is given 100 volt, right? Is given 100 volt. We have to find capacitance. So we know the capacitance of parallel plate capacitor is given by A epsilon naught upon D. In air K hota hai, K 1 ho gaya, aur yahan pe ho gaya A epsilon naught upon D. We know epsilon naught is equal to 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12 what? Newton meter square per coulomb square. To ye epsilon naught ki value hoti hai. Is per newton and per meter square coulomb square होता है. तो ये जो होता है, ये epsilon naught की unit जो होती है वो per newton per meter square coulomb square होती है. पर न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर कूलम्ब स्क्वायर होती. अब हम यहां पे रख देंगे कैपेसिटेंस C इज इक्वल टू, तो क्या होगा? तो C इज इक्वल टू, देयरफॉर C इज इक्वल टू, वी कैन राइट हियर C इज इक्वल टू क्या हो जाएगा? A, A का मतलब 6 * 10 टू द पावर -3, एप्सिलॉन नॉट का मतलब 8.854 * 10 टू द पावर -12 एंड डिवाइडेड बाय D, 3 into 10 to the power minus 3. 3 से 6 2 times cancel हो जाएगा. 2 4 जा 8 and 5 2 जा 10 carry 1, 8 2 जा 16 1 17 carry 1 and 8 2 जा 16 1 17. So 17.708 into 10 to the power minus 12 farad. That is 17.708 picofarad. This is the capacitance of capacitor. Now, there is a question that when 100 volt supply is connected, that is, what the question is, that agar 100 volt supply se connect kar diya jaye, ye capacitor hai, aur is capacitor ko 100 volt ki supply se connect kar diya jaye, isko, to charge dono pe kitna hoga, ye hai, isko 100 volt capacitor se supply kar diya jaye. तो चार्ज होगा यहां पे प्लस q होगा और यहां पे माइनस q होगा, चार्ज ऑन ईच प्लेट. तो ये कितना होगा? तो q इज इक्वल टू होता है cv, ठीक है. सो q इज इक्वल टू कितना, c कितना आया हमारा, c आया है 17.708 into 10 to the power minus 12 farad. और वोल्ट कितना है, वोल्ट है हमारा कितना, तो 100 वोल्ट. 100 से मल्टीप्लाई करने से ये हो जाएगा 17.708 into 10 to the power minus 12 volt, right ना? So that will be इतना volt का, sorry coulomb, इतना coulomb होगा charge unit है coulomb, और इसको pico coulomb भी कह सकते हैं 17 point, और इसको 100 N, ठीक है. तो ये हो गया 17708 पिको कूलम. सो दैट इज द आंसर. आई होप यू गॉट इट. ओके, नाउ द नेक्स्ट वन इज, नाउ इन दिस क्वेश्चन एक्सप्लेन व्हाट वुड हैपन इफ द कैपेसिटर गिवन इन एक्सरसाइज 2.8 ए 3 मिलीमीटर थिक माइका शीट व्हिच डाइलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट इज 6 वेयर इंसर्टेड बिटवीन द प्लेट्स व्हाइल द voltage supply remain connected and after the supply was disconnected. So this is the question. सो दिस इज इन रेफरेंस विद द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन, ये कहा जा रहा है कि इसमें जो प्लेट है ये 3 मिलीमीटर का जो डिस्टेंस है उसको माइका से भर दिया जाए जिसकी डाई इलेक्ट्रिक कॉन्स्टेंट जो है वो क्या है, 6 है। तो डाई इलेक्ट्रिक कॉन्स्टेंट 6 होने की वजह से इसके बीच में अगर हम ये फिल कर दें माइका दोनों प्लेट के बीच में तो क्या होगा। तो हमने कैपेसिटेंस जो है वो पढ़ा है कि डाइलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट होने से कैपेसिटेंस जो होगा वो क्या हो जाएगा, C1 इज इक्वल टू क्या हो जाएगा, K इंटू ए एप्सिलॉन नॉट अपॉन डी। ये इनिशियल कैपेसिटेंस है, दैट इज K टाइम्स ऑफ C0, वेयर C0 इज इनिशियल कैपेसिटेंस, A एप्सिलॉन नॉट अपॉन डी, डी सेम। तो K है यहाँ पे 6 और K कितना दिया हुआ है, 6, डाइलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट 6 दिया हुआ है। तो कैपेसिटेंस 6 टाइम्स ऑफ C0 हो जाएगा, और 6 टाइम्स ऑफ C0, 6 इंटू C0 कितना था, C0 था हमारा 17.708 समथिंग आया था, अभी आया था ना, देखो ध्यान से, 17.708 इंटू 10 टू दी पावर माइनस 12। सो 17.708 इंटू 10 टू दी पावर माइनस 12 यह आया था कैपेसिटेंस फैराड। सो ये 106.248 into 10 to the power minus 12 farad, that is approximately we can write here 106 picofarad, right now 106 picofarad. So new capacitance will be 106 picofarad. Now new capacitance is there and voltage is still same, V is 100 volt. Now so new charge C dash is equal to C1 into V, that is 100 into 106 picofarad, that is what, 106 into 100 is 1.06 into 10 to the power what, minus 10 coulomb, right, 10 to the power minus 12, and because this 20 will make it 10 to the power minus 10 coulomb. So 1.06, even 248 you can write, but this is coulomb, this is the new charge, 1.06 into 10 to the power 6 coulomb. So charge will increase, now the storage of charge will increase. Earlier the charge was not like this, a smaller charge, but now the charge will increase 1.06 into 10 to the power minus 10 coulomb, the storage will increase because of the dielectric. Now the thing is, when voltage is off, supply is off, then what will happen, supply is off, in this case charge on each plate will remain same. What was that charge? So the charge on each plate was initially, charge here, charge on each plate was, we have calculated here, charge on each plate was 17.708 into 10 to the power minus 12, 17.708 into 10 to the power minus 12, 10, 17.10, here it is 10, I can write 10. Because 20 will multiply, so that is why 20 will eliminate, or even when can write this one as 1.7, right now 708 into 10 to the power minus 9 coulomb, we can write. So 1.77 approximately, that is not more, 7 into 10 to the power minus 9 coulomb. So this is the charge initially. Now 1.77 into 10 to the power minus 9, so charge will be 1.77 into 10 to the power minus 9 coulomb, charge will remain same. And now what we have to calculate here in this question? In this question, we have to calculate that what will happen, explain what would happen if the after the supply was disconnected, then supply was disconnected, what would be the potential? V is still, because supply is connected, so no potential. So here what will happen? Now new capacitance, we have already calculated that new capacitance is like this, 1.606 into 10 to the power minus 10. So potential difference, in this case potential difference across the plate is given by what? So V is equal to Q by C, and Q is what? Charge is already 1.77 into 10 to the power minus 9, right? 10 to the power minus 9. Charge is this, and the C1 C dash is air C dash, in fact, yeah, C1, jo bhi hai, C1. So C1 is here, capacitance is, new capacitance is, sorry, 106 picofarad, that is 10 to the power, 1.06 into 10 to the power minus 12, 1.06, this we what we have already calculated here. You can see this capacitance was, new capacitance was 106 picofarad, that is 106 picofarad. So I can write here 106 picofarad, 106 into 10 to the power minus 12, or even we can write here this is 1.77 in upon 1.06, 10 to the power minus 9, and this is 10 to the power minus 10, right? So this will be 17.7 upon, even, or even we can write here 1.06, that is 1770 upon 106, which can be divided into 106 divided 177, and thus will come approximately equal to 16.7 volt. That will be the answer. So this is the question. Next question is question number 10. A 12 picofarad capacitor is connected to a 50 volt battery. How much electrostatic energy is stored in the capacitor? So this is a question. Here capacitance of capacitor is given as 12 picofarad, that is 12 into 10 to the power minus 12 farad, and voltage is given that 50 volt battery, this is the connected. We know the electrostatic energy E is equal to electrostatic energy, aapne formula to padhai hoga, hai na? Energy E is equal to half CV square. So this is half into C. What is C? C is here 12 into 10 to the power minus 12. Right? And CV is 50 square. That is 50 into 50. So this can be written as 6 times. 6, 5 is 30, and 35 is 150. And there are two more zeros into 10 to the power minus 12. Right, so this will be 30, that can be written as 1.5 into 10 to the power what, 1, 2, 3, 4 minus 8 volt, this electrostatic energy, that is in joule, that is in joule. So this is the answer. So it is the easiest question, I think so. If you remember the formula, you can do it. अगर फॉर्मूला आपको याद होंगे तो आप आसानी से कर सकते हैं. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन देखते हैं. अगला क्वेश्चन है हमारा क्वेश्चन नंबर 11, राइट? और इस क्वेश्चन में क्या है कि 600 पिको फैराड कैपेसिटर इज चार्ज्ड विद 200 वोल्ट सप्लाई. It is then disconnected from the supply and is connected to another uncharged 600 picofarad capacitor. One 600 picofarad capacitor is charged with 200 volt supply. It is then disconnected from the supply and connected to another 600 picofarad capacitor is the capacity, but this is not charged. How much electrostatic energy is lost in this process? This is the question. Now, in this question, one capacitor is connected with 200 volt supply, right? And this is a 200 volt supply. Capacitance is C. Then, what energy it can store? E is equal to half CV square, and therefore 1 by 2 into C is 600 picofarad. 600 into 10 to the power minus 12 farad, because C is given here 600 picofarad. That is 600 into 10 to the power minus 12, farad. So, this is what given. And V is 200 volt supply. So, 200 into 200. Now, so that will come up like 2 to the 4, 4, 3 to the 12 into 10 to the power minus 6 joule. Right now, or 1.2, in a standard form we can write 1.2 into 10 to the power minus 5 joule. This is what. Now, the second part of the question is, if this capacitor is connected to another uncharged capacitor, that is what will happen. One, this capacitor is connected with another capacitor, right? So, connector is there, one capacitor is C1, another capacitor is C2, then what will be the equivalent capacitance? Equivalent capacitance of the combination is given by 1 by C is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. In this case, what will happen? 1 by 600 picofarad plus 1 upon 600 picofarad, that is 2 upon 600 picofarad, that is 1 upon 300 picofarad, and therefore C is equal to 300 picofarad. Now, equivalent capacitance of the capacitor is, then what will the electrostatic energy? Then electrostatic energy with new capacitance E is equal to half of CV square. Now, this C is what? Even you can write C dash so that it can distinguish from the previous one. So, C dash V square. 1 by 2 C dash is 300 picofarad, that is 10 to the power minus 12, right now, 10 to the power minus 12. So, into 200 square, right now, 200 square, okay. Now, this will come up like earlier, what instead of 300 there was 600 and this is 300, rest of the things are same. So obviously that will be half of, earlier we have calculated that 1.2 into 10 to the power minus 5, 10 to the power 5 joule, and therefore what will happen, as we have calculated here, see this 10 to the power minus 5 joule, 1.2 into 10 to the power minus 5 joule. So, here this is half of this, because instead of 600 there was 300. So, half of this will be 0.6 into 10 to the power minus 5 joule, or 6 into 10 to the power minus 6 joule. This is the electrostatic energy, that is half of the energy will be lost. Simply half of the energy will be lost in this combination. Now, let us discuss question number. This question is, a charge of 8 microcoulomb is located at origin. Calculate the work done in taking a small charge of minus 2 into 10 to the power minus 9 coulomb minus this one, like here is charge. दिस इज एक्स एक्सिस यू नो एंड वाई एक्सिस एंड जेड एक्सिस, दिस इज एक्स एक्सिस, दिस इज वाई एक्सिस एंड दिस वन इज जेड एक्सिस, राइट। सो एक्स एक्सिस, वाई एक्सिस एंड जेड एक्सिस लाइक दिस। पॉइंट चार्ज इज, पॉइंट इज लोकेटेड एट पी 003, ऑफ कोर्स दिस इज ऑन जेड एक्सिस 003, सो जेड एक्सिस, एंड टू पॉइंट क्यू 040, 040, दिस इज ऑफ कोर्स ऑन वाई एक्सिस, सो दिस इज पॉइंट क्यू एंड दिस इज पॉइंट पी। एंड नाउ भाया आर, आर इज एक्स कोऑर्डिनेटेड 0, सो ऑफ कोर्स इट लाई इन वाई जेड प्लेन, वाई जेड प्लेन इज समवेयर लाइक सपोज हियर, वाई जेड प्लेन इज दिस पॉइंट वेयर एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट इज 0, सो वाई जेड प्लेन समवेयर लाइक दिस इज वाई दिस इज जेड, सो हियर सपोज आर, आर इज पॉइंट 069। Now, in question, it is described that the point is, this is origin, from P to R and then Q. P to, first move from P to R and then to Q. Work is path independent, everybody knows this. So, there is no problem with whether going with R or P to Q directly, or via R or via S or somewhere else, this doesn't make any difference. So potential work is what? Potential into charge. So potential at P, potential at P due to charge at O, at O is VAO, VOA, potential at A, potential at P, P point, so potential at P due to charge at O, even V1 and V2 we can write, not necessary that write in the symbol, V1 is equal to, kya ho jayega, KQ upon R1, aur R1 kya ho gaya, O se P ke beech ka distance, that is 3 cm, where R1 is 3 cm, that is 3 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter, right? Okay, now potential at Q, potential at Q due to charge at O, charge at origin O is V2, that is KQ by R2, where R2 is equal to what? Distance from origin, that is 4 centimeter, which is 4 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter, right? Now, potential difference between these two, so therefore potential difference is equal to V2 minus V1, that is KQ upon R2 minus KQ upon R1. That can be written as KQ 1 by R2 minus 1 by R1, right? Now, potential difference is this, and therefore work done in bringing the charges from P to Q, therefore work done in bringing charge Q naught, which is given as minus 2 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, from P to Q is given by work done is what? W is equal to potential into charge, and therefore we can write here, what is potential? W is equal to, potential is KQ 1 by R2 minus 1 by R1 into charge is what? Q naught. एंड ऑल वैल्यू इफ आई पुट हियर k is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9, that everybody know, 9 into 10 to the power 9, and q is what? 8 microcoulomb. So that is 8 into 10 to the power minus 3 coulomb, microcoulomb. This is 1 by 4 into 10 to the power, R2 is 1 by 4 into 10 to the power minus upon 1 upon 3 into 10 to the power minus 2. And q naught is minus 2 into 10 to the power minus 9. So all this we can calculate here is, first of all, this 10 to the power minus 2 will be 10 to the power 2 in numerator, and so it will come out 9 into 8 is 72. 72 into 2 is 144. Minus 144 into, this is 1 by 4 minus 1 by 3, that will come. And 10 to the power, 9 minus 3, 6, 6 and 2, 8, 8 and 10 to the power minus 9, so 10 to the power minus 1 will remain. Now that will be 1 minus 144 into, this is 3 minus 4, that is minus 1 by 12 into 10 to the power minus 1. 12 job, this minus minus plus, so this is 12, right, and 10 to the power minus 1, that is divided by 10, so that can be written as 1.2 joule. This is the amount of work done, total amount of work done in bringing charge from P to Q. So I hope you got it right now, and some more questions we will discuss in the next class. Thank you. Till then, bye-bye.